Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. Today I am coming up with another interesting topic, that is how to study astrology. So whenever I conduct online classes or actual classes on astrology, this is a question the people who come for enrolling ask, like, you know, how to study astrology and when can we start practicing? These are the two questions. Now, how long does it take to astrology? Let us understand first. Astrology is actually a lifelong study. No one can claim mastery into it, not even me. I have been studying for the past 30 years, but still there are so many things what I don't know and I keep on updating you how to get into it. More and more you study, more and more you are drawn into it, you know. On everyday basis, like, you have to update your knowledge, you have to apply your knowledge. So you need to study. So this is, there is no quick or a definite period or a quick way, a quick shortcut to, you know, this mystic science. It requires your time, your dedication, like any other form of art. Like, if you want to become a real good classical music singer, like, you know, you need to devote your entire life. Same thing with, the classical dances, like West or East, whatever. So you have to better yourself each day. That is such an in-depth this thing. I have been learning and practicing astrology for the last 30 years, but I still feel I don't know many things. See, for example, I'll tell you, like, you know, this is one book on astrology. This is Brihat Jataka Hora Shastra. This is 1200 pages. Do you think I will know all the rules and all the formulae what they have given in Sanskrit and their meaning in, by heart? It's not possible. Human brain cannot comprehend. But like I keep on reading, I keep on refreshing. If any interesting horoscope is there, I tally it and see. Now I come to the second part. Actually, it is so interesting that you are drawn towards it, like, you know, and it's a kind of a mystery. Like, once you know the basics, you start, applying the rules and checking them. Now, how to do this? See, you cannot wait for the client, okay, you pay me this much and I'm going to check, I have learned astrology, nobody will come to you also. So what you have to do is study your own horoscope, your relatives, your friends. Also, there are books available where sample horoscopes are, you know, compiled. And there are horoscopes of famous personalities available online. Don't read the interpretation given by others. Then you will be clouded in your thinking. Then you tend to believe whatever others have written is right. No. If you have learned certain rules, take the patrika, take those horoscopes and try to apply, like, you know, okay, sun's position is here, moon's position is here and Rahu and Ketu, whatever. So you apply that and you see. Like that, actually, I have bought the books with the compiled patrikas or the horoscopes, and also I have analyzed so many horoscopes which are already there on the internet. Even like, you know, our national leaders who are no more there, like Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra, everything. Their birth details are available and these days it is so easy. When I was learning 30 years back, I had to, we learned to compute it, all the mathematical calculations and chart casting. That itself was a tedious task. But now it is at the click of a button. But only thing is dedication is needed. And also see, for learning the basics, to be very honest, you cannot read the book and learn astrology because it requires some guidance. There are so many layers and layers to it. It's not as easy as you think, okay, sun and moon, sun is like this, moon is like this. It's not something to by heart or, you know, get to know. You have to develop insight, you have to meditate, you have to get to it. So teacher is very, very, very much needed here. I have done like actually 2 years course and then one year course. So like that, I have done the courses. Plus, I have studied. Then actually, once you finish your basic astrology and little bit of advanced astrology, your real study begins. That is where I told you buy the, I mean, you collect the horoscopes and start analyzing. That is where your real study begins. And after that also, like, you know, if you have seen Patrika of your own relatives or whatever, so you try to see their physical people, physical appearance, and then their behavior, and their traits and mannerisms, and associate with the planets what you are studying. So constantly you need that chintan, constantly you need to learn that. Vedic astrology is based on the prediction of, you know, combination, basic I'm talking. There is something called as moon sign, depending on where your moon is placed in the horoscope. And then there is sun sign, looking at the position of the sun in your horoscope. And then there is ascendant, that's a rising sign. This is just a basic thing. But apart from this, there are so many divisional charts. Like, you know, Namavamsha Kundali, Saptamamsha Kundali, or they are called as D9 chart, D10 chart, D9 chart for all the well-being. And then D10 chart is if you want to study your, your karma kshetra, that is about your work and your job or whatever, those kind of things, like, you know, that is there. So, and if you want to study about the marriage of a person, then the 7D7 chart. So like that, so many divisional charts are there. Then there is something called as Ashtakavarga study. But all these advanced things, you should complete your basics and then try to study. First, you just have started, learning about the planets. Don't end up in, Ashtakavarga and other things. Like, you won't make head or tail out of it. You have to. And also, Krishnamurti Paddhati is another beautiful branch of astrology. See, this, you know, like, in case the person doesn't know his birth time or, you know, whatever, like, his birth details are missing, how to see such kundalis or how to predict such people. Krishnamurti has found out a method for this. So, when the querent, means the person who is asking a question, goes to the house of an astrologer, goes to the astrologer, at that time, whatever is the position of the planets is taken into consideration and the chart is cast, and based on that the predictions are done. That's called as Hora Shastra also, like, you know, depending on the horary astrology or like answering the questions. But it will answer a typical question. You cannot ask your entire life about that. And also Krishnamurti also warns that intent of the querent should be very, very genuine. You should not go to an astrologer with the intention of testing their knowledge. Or let us see, you know, I know this person, so he is doing, let me go and do where I am going to pay money, just do time pass. No, please don't do that. And also don't ask anybody for free. That will not be good for you, because you are going there to cleanse your karmas, and karma cleansing has to be compensated with something. So you need to pay, you need to, energy exchange has to be there. So you should never take anything for free, especially astrology in life, you know. So by your intention are genuine, and then you really approach an astrologer, Krishnamurti Paddhati works wonders. Trust me when I say this. So, basic studies first you have to complete, and then you have to go for the advanced. Then you study divisional charts. Once you have the grip on that knowledge on that subject, then you can go for Krishnamurti Paddhati or KP astrology, as it is popularly known as. And there are also different systems. Basic is the same. There is a Parashari. There is one school of thought called as Parashari Likhita astrology. Then, as I mentioned, KP astrology. So, but basic things are almost the same. So, I hope you find this useful information. So, do learn. And this is very fascinating. And it really, really empowers you. It's always, you know, like, what is said in the Shastras is, whatever we earn, our money, then gadi, bangla, everything, whatever we have, all our position, including our body, remains on this earth only. We are not going to carry anything over. So, what the soul carries is only the knowledge. So, grab knowledge wherever you get. That's why I am very fascinated. Whatever is new, I want to learn. Whatever is, you know, something that fascinates me, I really learn. So, happy learning. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you. And if you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you. Shubham.